no more war, and the opportunity to grow and to prosper, to build and to plant, to live out their lives in peace, to secure a safe future. In the north of Israel, members of a kibbutz celebrate Shavuot, a double celebration, marking the giving of the law at Mount Sinai and the harvesting of the season's first fruits. The realities of life are often painful and difficult, but a new generation of Israelis is striving to overcome the problems that have beset this small land. And in their striving, they will create, through the examples of their lives, a new expression of Jewishness. The Jews of Israel will always draw strength and inspiration from the memory of their past. They share with Jews everywhere a sense of history, a set of ideals. For a sanctified memory is what holds the Jewish people together. They remember, at this Festival of Tabernacles, events lost in the mists of time. The wandering through the deserts of Sinai, and the first and greatest Jewish contribution, the idea of the one God. They remember, at this, the western wall of Herod's temple, all the history of their part in the ancient world, and their sense of themselves as a nation. They remember the millennium of the European sojourn, the persecutions and golden times of their ongoing dispersion, and the fulfillment of the Zionist dream. Throughout their complex history, they have continued to evolve as a unique and remarkable civilization. They have borrowed from and contributed to the many cultures with which they have been in contact. In the rich variety of their lives, they reflect the variety of all civilization. The story of the Jews has an astonishing resonance. Their strange destiny, their achievements, their suffering and their vision are an enduring part of civilization, for civilization is the bringing together of the memories and the experiences of all peoples. We are, all of us, the children of history, and for the enrichment of our world, we must try, each of us, to understand our heritage, to judge it in the light of its highest values, and to pass it on as a treasure for all mankind. This is the message of the Jews to the world.
Thank you. Major funding for this program has been provided by the Charles H. Revson Foundation, Petrie Stores Corporation, and the National Endowment for the Humanities. Additional funding has been provided by the following contributors. A complete donor list is available at WNET. Abba Iban has written a companion book to this series, which is published by Summit Books and is available in bookstores and libraries.